बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम। वेलकम टू इंटरनेशनल इस्लामिक यूनिवर्सिटी इस्लामाबाद स्कूल साहिवाल कैंपस ऑनलाइन लेक्चर्स। दिस इज़ द लेक्चर ऑफ ग्रेड 5 इंग्लिश यूनिट नंबर 2 डायलॉग। डियर स्टूडेंट्स, इन द प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी स्टार्टेड दिस लेसन। वी हैव कवर्ड रीडिंग एंड अंडरस्टैंडिंग फ्रॉम द कॉन्टेंट ऑफ दिस लेसन। आई हैव गिवन यू द मीनिंग्स ऑफ डिफिकल्ट वर्ड्स एंड फ्रेजेज and you have written those meanings and of words and phrases in your English classwork notebook. I hope you all have understood the content of this lesson. Today we are going to move towards the exercise of this lesson, and the first part of the exercise is question answers. Dear students, as you already have understood the content of this lesson, so this is not difficult for you to answer the questions, because these questions are extracted from the content of the lesson and you already have done reading and understanding of the lesson. So let's move towards the lecture number 2 of our unit number 2. Before we begin, make sure that you have your English student's book, your English classwork notebook and your complete stationery with you. Listen to the teacher attentively and write down the stuff asked by teacher in your English classwork notebook. Note down the points that you don't understand and wait for the discussion session. Write down date and day on the page number 13 from your student's book. Dear students, please open your student's book, page number 13. Write down date, classwork and day on the top of this page, because in today's lesson we are going to cover the questions from this page. Open your English classwork notebook and prepare your classwork page by writing date and day on the top of the page. Topic is dialogue and the subtopic is questions. Please prepare your index properly. Now let's come to the questions from page number 13 of your student's book. And the question number 1 is, who taught the pupils to play quick cricket in Rabia's school? Dear students, please write down the question in your English classwork notebook on the classwork page that you have prepared for today's lecture. Who taught the pupils to play quick cricket in Rabia's school? Yes, dear students, do you remember who taught the pupils to play quick cricket in her school? We already have covered reading and explanation of the content of this lesson. I hope you all remember that who was he? Who was their coach who taught them to play quick cricket in their school? Yes, you can find the answer in the first section of this dialogue, where Rabia tells her mother about the sports coach who came to their school to teach them how to play quick cricket. So the answer of this question is, Mr. Kashif, the sports coach, taught them. Write down this question and its answer in your classwork page. Now come to the question number 2. Read out the question. Why did Rabia and her friends borrow some cricket equipments? Dear students, please write down this question in your English classwork notebook. Why did Rabia and her friends borrow some cricket equipments? Yes, do you remember, dear students, Rabia and her friends, some of the girls, borrowed some cricket equipments to practice at home. Why did they do so? Yes, the cricket equipments were for their whole class. Their coach arranged some cricket equipments for their whole class to practice at school, but some of the girls borrowed those equipments because boys didn't let them play at school. Boys didn't let them use those equipments at school for practice. So some of the girls decided to borrow some of the equipments, some bat and wickets and stumps home to practice. So the answer we have found that because the boys didn't let them practice at school. Write down this question and its answer in your English classwork notebook. Come to the question number 3, and the question is, how did Rabia's mother know that she is worried? Write down this question in your English classwork page. Yes, dear students, do you remember that Rabia's mother came to know that she is worried? How did she come to know? You can find the answer in the very first line of this lesson, where her mother says that, what's wrong? You have been quiet all evening. You hardly touched your dinner. In this sentence, we can find the answer of this question, that Rabia's mother came to know that she is worried because she had been quiet all the evening and didn't touch her dinner. So the answer is, because Rabia had been quiet all evening and did not touch her dinner. Write down this question and its answer in your English classwork notebook. Come to the next question, question number 4. How do you think Rabia felt before she spoke to Mr. Kashif? Yes, dear students, when Rabia told her mother about the whole situation and her mother said her to go the next morning to Mr. Kashif and tell him the complete situation, that they had borrowed some equipments and have lost some of the stumps. Next morning, she had to go to Mr. Kashif to tell the truth. What do you think before telling to Mr. Kashif, how was she feeling? Yes, it can be understood that Rabia must be feeling the something afraid. She was worried that when Mr. Kashif would come to know about that they borrowed some equipments and now have lost some of the things, he would punish them, he would scold them. She must be afraid of being punished by Mr. Kashif. So the answer is, she was afraid of being scolded by Mr. Kashif. She was afraid of being punished by Mr. Kashif. You can also say this. Write down this question and its answer in your English classwork notebook. Come to the question number 5. Dear students, you are not required to write down this question in your notebook, because this question is to be filled on your book. Here a statement is given, and for this statement 4 optional statements are given, and you are required to pick the correct one from these 4 and encircle or mark tick on the correct one. So the given statement is, Mr. Kashif thought Rabia was brave because. Yes, dear students, Mr. Kashif thought that Rabia is brave. He said her that, Rabia, it was brave of you to tell me. Why did he think so? Mr. Kashif thought Rabia was brave because. Option A is, she took the equipments. Was this thing brave of her that she borrowed the equipments home? Option B is, she told the truth. Was it the matter of bravery that she told him the truth? Option C is, she borrowed the equipments back. Did she brought the equipment back? No, not all the equipments were brought back, because some of the stumps were lost. Option D is, she bought some new equipment. Did she buy some new equipment? No, here she claims that she will replace but haven't bought some new equipments yet. So I think correct answer is, she told him the truth, option B. Encircle the option B, it is the correct one. She told the truth. Now come to the question number 6. Here again, this question is also not to be written on your classwork notebook, because this question again has some options to be filled or to be encircled or to be marked, tick on your book. So you are not required to write down this question in your English classwork notebook. And the question is, which of the following would be the best title for the passage? Yes, dear students, in the previous unit we saw that there was a name of unit and a title of the content. Here in this unit the name of unit is given, which is dialogue, but dialogue's title is not given. You are required to pick the correct title from these four options. And the option A is learn to share, was the as a whole the matter was to learn to share. Option B is boys are unfair. Dear students, are boys unfair all the time? In this lesson it can be said that boys behaved unfair, but it can't be said as a statement that boys always are unfair or boys are unfair all the time. It can't be said. Some of the times boys behave unfair, some of the times girls behave unfair, and some of the times both are correct on their points. So I think this is not the title. This should not be the title of this lesson, because if we mark it as a title, it will become a statement, and this can't be said as a statement. These boys are unfair. So option C is cricket is for boys and girls. Option D is winning at cricket. Is there the matter of winning at cricket? No. In the end of this lesson, Mr. Kashif says them that this is not fair. Cricket is not just about winning matches. So it shows that the correct title cannot be that winning at cricket. So the correct option or correct title, most appropriate title, is option A, learn to share. Mark, tick or encircle the option A, learn to share. Mark it on your English student's book. Come to the question number 7. Write down this question in your English classwork notebook. Why does Mr. Kashif say that the boy's behavior is not fair? Yes, dear students, why did he say so, that boy's behavior is not fair? Why did he feel the boy's behavior not fair? Yes, because boys didn't let the girls use cricket equipment. So he thought that boy's behavior is not fair. Okay, dear students, this is the end of today's lecture. Now let's discuss our homework for today. From your English students book, page number 13, from where we have done the questions, question number 1 to 7. Now you are required to write down answers of question number 8, 9 and 10 in your English homework notebook. Dear students, you are required to write down this homework in a very proper manner by writing the date and day on the top of the page. You will prepare your index properly and write down these questions and their answers respectively in your English homework notebook. Dear students, get your homework done by the next lesson and follow the given instructions properly. If you find anything difficult or anything that you don't understand while doing your homework, just note down the points and wait for the discussion session. This is the end of today's lesson. Good luck, students. Allah Hafiz.